Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to attempt to loosen up the hinges on this Lenovo T440 because at the moment I'm going to zoom on this corner right here. They are way too tight. You can see the deformation while I try to move it, and you can see there is lots of accumulated stress. So let's get to it. You might be wondering why I bother myself with this. Well, this is the next step exactly in that area on an identical laptop. So I'm trying to prevent this one from reaching this point because this is way too tight. There is no need for it to be this tight. As you can see, we are putting a lot of stress on these hinges, and this is valid for almost every laptop out there that gets hot and the oils in the hinge dry up and it's way tighter than it was meant to be. Mostly there are brands of laptops that have some, I don't know, problems of their own. For example, I've encountered a lot of Lenovos with hinge problems, either the case breaking or the hinge itself when it's out made of magnesium breaking. So Lenovos tend to have problems with hinges, at least from what I am working on. The laptops that get in my hand, this is true about them. On HPs, for example, lots of them have problems with batteries not being recognized and whatnot, although they are fairly new. I don't know, Toshibas, for example, they are losing stuff like this when it's just a cover. If you have a Toshiba, there is a chance that cover will fall. Many times they just have them right in the corner here, they fall off. Clevo laptops lose hinge covers. What else? On Dells, many of them have the top made of an aluminium sheet, and that one gets bent really easily and scratched. Yeah, whatever. But on Lenovo's, the hinges are too tight. On Asus, Acer, whatever, Samsung, I didn't get to work on enough. Toshiba, I worked on enough. Fujitsu, Siemens, I didn't get to work on enough of them, so I have a clear experience with most problems. But yeah, on these ones, hinges, so if they are too tight, open up the laptop and loosen them up a little bit, and I will show you how to do that on this particular model at least. You should be quite similar. So on this version, or actually I need to put something underneath it so I will not scratch it. On this one you can see I removed the rubberized layer, so it's quite shiny now and I don't want to scratch it, so I will put some cloth underneath it. Be right back. First thing, remove the battery. On some other laptop models actually, it might be required to access the hinges from the front. I will just show you what exactly I mean by that. They do have a few screws here which you might need to take off, but on my channel and on many other channels there are lots of disassembly videos, so maybe one shows exactly for your laptop how to do it. So you would disassemble those screws and then just take this top part off. If you see that it's cut here and here, usually it means you can just take that one off by undoing the screws from the back for it. On this one it's a whole piece, so it's impossible to be done. The idea is you need to get to those hinges, so search for disassembly videos online and whatnot. But for this particular one, I need to take out the whole back of it. no other way around it. If you do this blindly, meaning you didn't find this is not its original screw, so it's not captive, so I must not lose it. So if you are unable to find a teardown video or a disassembly video online, make sure you do lots of pictures so you remember every single screw exactly from where it came from, and I'm thinking you should mostly be good. The laptops are not that complicated. This thing just has clips now all around, so I am undoing those. But they are pretty strong, so this laptop is not real happy to be coming apart. I just need something like this to pry it out. And I'm thinking I missed a screw. No, shouldn't. Shouldn't have missed any screws. But something still seems to be holding us. So I'm thinking this clip right in there. So maybe I will move it a bit forward towards us. Yep, that was it. As you can see, the hinges are exactly here. So for me, this was rather easy. If you end up opening it up, make sure the hinges are tight. Do not over tighten them. Just make sure they are tight. That's enough. And at this point, you can put a little bit of oil on them. So I'm going to go grab some oil and be back in a second. You know what? I decided against the oil because I remembered I have some of this silicone grease. This is meant for coffee making. Oh, it's already dripping. Coffee making machines. So it plays nicely with plastic and whatnot, and it's actually fairly thin. So maybe it is actually better than the oil and has bigger chances of staying where I put it. So just make sure you cover the hinge. Maybe don't overdo it, because that would actually be pretty bad once again, but in the other direction. Maybe the hinge will be too loose by then. Let me just zoom on the hinge, be back. If you only have, I don't know, motor oil or something like that, use that. Don't overdo it once again. I think this is enough what I put around here. And slowly, when you use it, this will get between those plates, because it has metal plates and then it has some metal, there are something, they act as springs, so they push, they make sure everything has just enough friction in there, so it holds your screen in place but doesn't let it fall or go up too hard. But in our case, it is going up a little bit too hard, so this is why we are putting the oil. And I will do even something a bit different, just to make sure that we are okay. I will undo this, but just a tiny bit. But be careful if you do this. Don't break anything. And don't undo it too much. Yeah, just slipped. Maybe it was better to do this before I have put this grease on it. Yeah, slipping like crazy now that I also have this on my pliers. Maybe from another angle, just a tiny bit. Make sure you know the direction in which this thing tightens. So righty tighty, lefty loosey. I think that's the correct wording for it. But it's quite impossible. It went just a tiny bit, but it's not going more. Oh, okay, just went a bit more. So it is a bit looser at this point than it was before. So I'm just going to do exactly the same thing on the other hinge, and then I will test it and see how everything is working. Okay, I'm going to try and give you a close-up on how a hinge works. Metal is just sliding one next to the other. And that's about it. The friction has to be just right. And the friction is controlled by how much oil is in between them and how tight this screw at the end is. So I will loosen up that screw a bit more and play with the hinge until the grease that we put in there goes in between those plates. To have a better chance of grease reaching all the points, I've actually opened up two screws, and now I can play with this hinge by hand any way that I want. So I will force it to travel a bit more than it was actually somehow intended to, let's say like that. So now this grease will end up where it has to, because it's impossible for it not to from all the directions. And I will play with it like this until I feel it going easier. Okay, if I did this, I could actually move this away. Don't overdo it, because we are still attached to the hinge on the other part, so we don't want to break anything. And now I have way better access for a better tool to rotate this. I wish I had a socket. I had this small, but I don't think I have it, so this clamp will do just fine. If you look down in there, you can see that black stuff. That is the old grease that is starting to come out. That was dried out. The new one that I put in made it soft once again. If you really want to do this, you can wipe everything off and put new grease once again. But in my book, this is good enough. We have soft on the old one. This is moving way easier now. This screw is in the position that I want it. I will do the same on the other hinge, put it back together, and all should be okay. Just wanted to add, if you ever want to tighten the hinges, you simply do everything in reverse. You clean as much of the oil or grease as you can and tighten this screw right here. This should be valid for all sorts of laptops. If you want to go even further, you can actually open this up. Every single one of these, metal springs. There are some discs with a hole in the middle, which actually keep the pressure on the hinge. You need to take them out, clean them, but make sure you put them back exactly in the same position. So if you decide to do that, that's a bit more risky, because if you put them in a wrong position, they will not work as intended, and that could be a problem. You might think I'm exaggerating for a dramatic effect. No, this is how tight this hinge is. from this small arm of the force is it is this hard to rotate it. With a bigger, I don't know, a lever, how you call it in English, I have no clue. Obviously you will rotate it way easier, but with your hand directly at this size, it's really hard to rotate. So we do not want this, because all of this force goes directly into the cover of this particular laptop, which is quite thin. Other laptops have this way longer, which is way better at distributing the force, but Lenovo decided that their frame is strong enough to take this. We have seen on the other laptop that it isn't, and also this one is starting to show us that it isn't, and we don't want to wait for the end result. Sadly, I don't think I can get this out of the way enough, or I might be able to do it. Yep, I think I'm going to be able to do it. These wires are a bit shorter on this side than on the other side, so it's a bit harder to do what I need. But I still think I can get away with it. Yep. Perfect. There isn't enough room, and I don't have the proper tools to do this. Oh, this is extremely tight. This is not going to end well for me. I have a hunch. This is going to go bad. Impossible to move it with this. It's actually strong enough to damage it. Okay, back to the drawing board. Wait a moment. I might actually have the cure for this disease. Which is it? Nope. Is it a 5 millimeter? Yep, it's a 5 millimeter. Now we need this thing to go in or something. Probably this. Nope. My bad. Stupid. This is the right tool for the job. And hold on to the hinge. And hope nothing breaks. Whoa, this is tight. Damn, this is tight. Okay, I think I'm going to break this if I try more, so I don't want to do that. In which situation? I think I'm going to leave this on and have something else on this side. Something way stronger. Or maybe this thing, if it can get a hold of it. Okay. Maybe it's enough. I don't really know. Going. We are starting to loosen this thing up. Let's see. We are almost at the same level as on the other side, so I'm thinking that this might actually be enough. We don't want to overdo it, because then the top of the display could close itself. Yeah, this is quite quite easy going, so we overdid it. Way better than before. And we still don't have all the grease penetrated, so I think I'm going to leave it at this, and in time it will be going even a bit easier. But as you can see, I can actually lift it with my hand before I needed to use the pliers to get it out of this position. So now with the pliers it's nothing. Okay, let's tighten everything up and we should be good to go. As you could see, our hinges are way too loose at this particular moment in time, so we will tighten both of them just a tiny bit. This is not an exact science. You need to have them just enough that they hold the display by themselves, but not enough so they break. Okay, I think this side is perfect now. If you end up disassembling the hinges just like I did, so you can move them a little bit, make sure you put the screws just where they need actually to be. In my case, in two of the holes, and the third hole on both sides on both hinges needs to go also to the back plate. So only these two need to be put in at this point, and this one will be going through the whole assembly once we put on the back plate. So make sure you are careful about stuff like this, because you will not be able to assemble it back together if not. When checking if they are exactly how tight they need to be, don't be fooled by the fact that from a lower point it might try to close by itself. When you pull it higher, the force in the hinges is increased. The shape of the hinges is made in such way that at a lower point it knows that you want to close it, and it will close. Because if it were only about the direction of the forces or something like that, it would do the same thing when it would be here. It would try to go down by itself, but it doesn't. Here it stays exactly where you put it. So zero problems with that. Which means that this is not a problem, this is actually a feature. Under a certain point it closes by itself. So, yeah, you could tighten it that it goes exactly at, probably about here is that point, but mine starts to close by itself a bit higher probably than it should. But I prefer it like this than break my hinges. You could try and tighten it even more, play around with it, but no, I prefer them a bit looser so I don't risk anything. And they are not wobbly at all. So they stay where you put them, which is perfect for me. So let's put this whole thing back together. And of course, don't put your oily fingers on the case like I did, because that is just plain stupid. I need to clean it now. Okay guys, and this is it. This is how you adjust the hinges on a laptop so you don't have nearly as much force on the hinges. There is still some force on that area by design, which we cannot get rid of. It would mean they wouldn't put up a fight at all and our screen would just fall. But the force is way less than what it was when we started to make this video. So thank you for watching. If this video helps you, please give it a like. Check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel for future tech related videos and DIY stuff and whatnot. And as always, see you in the next one. Bye.